officer, Javier Vera.
From Warrior Stadium, it's Friday night Texas high school football. Tonight, the final non-district tune-up for the Piper Warriors as they host the undefeated Hallettsville Brahmas. Good evening, and thank you so much for joining us. I'm Paul Alexander, working alongside my partner, Joey Gonzalez. And Joey, we have a Class 5A team in Piper going up against a 3A Hallettsville program, but this is by no means a mismatch.
No, it's not, Paul. These teams played each other last year in Hallettsville, and the Brahmas won. Beyond that, Hallettsville has multiple Division I college prospects on its rosters, led by 6'3", 200-pound junior quarterback Jorion Wilson. Piper coach Nick Rogers says Wilson may be the best quarterback the Warriors face all season.
Well, for sure, the Brahmas are rolling. They're 3-0 with wins over Shiner, Flatonia, and Van Vleck. Their defense has pitched two straight shutouts. Hallettsville hasn't been scored on since opening night back on August 25th, and the Brahmas only gave up 8 points in that one. The Warriors on the season are 2-1 and are coming off last Friday's last-second win at Davenport.
That was a classic. The Warriors had to rally late to win 34-31. Daniel Miranda kicked a 32-yard field goal as time expired to lift Piper to that win. But that game also marked the emergence of a new star for Piper. Junior wide receiver Isaiah Champagne played for the first time this season following an eligibility dispute. Champagne popped his cork for 104 yards on 7 receptions and a touchdown, and Piper senior Nolan Doss caught 2 more TD passes and now is 6 on the season.
Joey, the Warriors are dealing with at least 3 injuries tonight. Right tackle Colton Green is out after banging up his left knee late in that win over Davenport. Senior outside linebacker Landon Ashpaw is out. And late word comes that defensive back Bennett King will miss tonight's game as well. As for conditions, well, they're a little bit different tonight than they've been for the first 3 weeks of the season.
Yeah, Paul, the first 3 weeks were hot and they're sunny. The sun has gone down a little bit. It's cloudy as well, 85 degrees with a high of 91 today and a low of 70, and wind coming in 7 miles per hour from the east.
We'll send our officiating crew for the evening. The crew chief, the referee, is Thaddeus Chase. Earl Tovar is our umpire tonight. The head linesman is Robbie Morish. The line judge, Matthew Swanson. Michael Frank will serve as the back judge tonight. The side judge is Brett Ullman. And Cy Fondle is the field judge. The Piper captains are number 7, Jake Strachan, number 8, Jake South, number 4, David Huntsman, and number 28, Landon Ashpaw, although he will miss the game tonight. Nick Rogers is the head coach of the Piper Warriors. Levi Montgomery is his counterpart at Hallettsville. And Joey, as we get ready for kickoff, Piper won the toss and elected to defer, so Hallettsville gets the ball first.
Yeah, so that means we get to see Coach Nick Rogers' defense. This is a team who has allowed the second fewest points in the district, just behind that of Kerrville Tyvee with 29.
For your safety.
All right, so it turned out to be a great night for football. Lovely evening. A little bit of a wardrobe change for the Warriors tonight. They're wearing white pants for the first time this season. They've worn gold breeches in the previous 3 games. Warriors have had a good week of practice, and they do have that shiny new weapon in Isaiah Champagne.
Isaiah Champagne's going to be a lot of fun to talk about and watch today. 7 receptions last week. Paul, who knows how many he's going to have
on
this week.
On your feet, Warriors!
Logan Lopez is set to kick it off for the Warriors as we reach the 4th Friday night of the high school football regular season. And Joey, it just goes by so fast.
I mean, it's been flying by, and this team's a lot of fun to watch, and I cannot wait for week 4 of this high school football season.
We don't have to wait much longer for football tonight. We're awaiting the referee's whistle. There it is. And with this, we are playing the great game. Short kick. It's going to be taken at about the 38-yard line, and really kind of a nice scoop up there by Deshaun Price for Hallettsville, which will start the evening with the football. And as we mentioned in the pregame show, they are quarterbacked by Jorion Wilson, just a spectacular athlete at 6'3", 200, one of the really highly regarded quarterbacks. And Joey, you know him as a baseball player.
Yeah, if you look at his perfect game account, this is a guy who could do it all, third base, shortstop, outfield, and a pitcher. This guy is going to be fun to watch.
Drive starts officially from the 40. Warriors in a 3-man defensive front. On first down, running play coming left side. Ball carrier hit behind the line of scrimmage. back at the 39.
If you're new to Piper football, that's something that you're going to see on the rushing defense. Everybody combines so quickly, gets to the edge in time. Three guys combined for the tackle and a loss of a yard.
That was Deshaun Price, fine senior running back for the Brahmas on the carry. Setting up second and 11 with the ball on the near hash mark. Two receivers to the far side. Now motion across the formation. That's Michael Pagoda. Two-back shotgun this time on second down. Again, running play, left side. And that's Lane Durkee on the carry. And he gets back to the original line of scrimmage and maybe a yard more, so a two-yard gain, setting up a third and nine.
Nice tackle there by the Piper defense, forcing third and long. And against an explosive quarterback like this, the Piper defense needs to force these third and very longs.
They go with the straight three-man front. Warriors in their 3-3-5 defensive alignment. Two receivers to the far side. Wilson wants to throw, does so. Throws it to the far side, has a completion to Ty Tomek, but he's brought down a well short of first down yardage. And on their first possession, the Brahmas go three and out.
Well, it's a really good defensive start here from this Piper defense, allowing only 4 yards of positive offense for this Brahmas team. And now we're going to have a chance to look at the Piper offense.
Now bring up fourth down, Warriors.
Ty Tomek is the punter with his heels squarely on his 30-yard line. Punt is away. It's a pretty good one. It's rolling toward the end zone. Takes a lateral hop, but gets just inside the pylon. So the Warriors catch a little bit of a break there as the ball goes into the end zone. So we'll have a touchback, and we'll get our first look of the night at a Warriors offense that's averaging 34 points per game and coming off a 34-point performance a week ago tonight in that big win at Davenport.
The Piper team has already scored 102 games through three games this season. They like to throw the ball through the air. Lots of receivers that quarterback Jake South can throw the ball to, and that should be something that the Brahmas defense is going to watch for in this game.
It's a Hallisville defense that has pitched two straight shutouts and is giving up only about 2 points a game through the first three games of the season. From the 20 following the touchback, South is the quarterback. Screen far side. It's complete, but it's complete behind the line of scrimmage. That's Jake Strachan on the reception, but he's actually going to lose a yard, maybe a yard and a half, as we roll inside 10 minutes remaining here in the opening period.
A week ago, Jake Strachan, 9 receptions for 68 yards, averaging 7.5 a catch.
Second and a little more than 11, running play coming near side. That's John Hamilton on the carry. Ball's on the ground. Hallisville thinks they have it. We're awaiting the signal.
Fumble on the play.
That's Ty Tomek, the linebacker who's also the kicker on the recovery for Hallettsville. So that's quite a blow there as the Warriors turn it over on their second play from scrimmage.
Yeah, and Hallettsville getting the ball in the red zone just outside the 10-yard line. Paul, one thing that we need to watch for in this game, Piper needs to find a way to get the rushing game going.
That's been a problem for the last 2 weeks. On first down from the one-back gun, the quarterback, Wilson. Running play, off right tackle. Ball carrier breaks a tackle, breaks two tackles, and into the end zone goes Deshaun Price, the fine senior running back for the Brahmas, who strike first.
Deshaun Price just pinballing off of the Piper defenders there, gets to the outside edge, and just a good job there by the Brahmas capitalizing on the fumble inside the own 20 for Piper.
So Tomek, who recovered the fumble moments ago, is on for the PAT, trying to give his team a 7-0 lead. The holder is Tanner Cliff. Ball is up and on its way, and it's good. And with 9:33 remaining in quarter number one, Hallettsville takes a 7-0 lead. Back with a kickoff in just a moment, right here on the Warriors Sports Network.
Brahmas 7. Warriors 0.
All right, Joey, so Hallettsville first forces a turnover and then cashes it in.
Yeah, it is one play, 11 yards. Deshaun Price bounced off of two defenders against Piper, and that is how Hallettsville takes a 7-0 lead with 9:33 to go in quarter number one.
All right, so we'll see if the Warriors can get something going here. We just can't stress this enough. There obviously is a difference in the student body enrollment with these two schools. But when you look at this actual team and roster at Hallettsville, they have maybe a half dozen Division I prospects.
Yeah, we talked about it in pregame. This is a quarterback who can play the ball well. On the defensive side, we're going to see that as well for this Hallettsville team. Piper's going to have their hands full from the start of this game.
So a touchback on the kickoff. And the Warriors will take the field offensively, looking to perhaps tie this up at 7. That first possession was absolutely disastrous as they fumbled the ball away, leading directly to a Hallettsville touchdown.
It's just a struggle from the rushing game. Paul, another thing we've talked about prior to this game, the struggles on first down. They need to find a way to move the ball forward.
We'll see what they do on this particular first down. From the 25, South, the quarterback, rolls to his left, pulls the trigger, has a receiver, and that is Isaiah Champagne. And they wasted no time getting him in the game plan.
Isaiah Champagne is going to be a fun player to watch as the season rolls on. An easy target there for Jake South and an easy 12-yard pickup there.
And a first down at the 38-yard line. Three receivers, actually four, to the near side of the formation. Three-man defensive front for Hallettsville. South throws over the middle and just misses his intended receiver, Nolan Doss. And Joey, it looked to me, if they made connections, he's still running, and that would have been his seventh touchdown reception of the season.
You bring that ball about a foot lower, Nolan Doss, that's right in his grasp. And Paul, as you mentioned, he would have gone to the house and tied this ball game up.
Evan Drake is the lone wide receiver to the near side. He is a big guy from the one-back gun. South with time this time, pulls it down, now throws, and the guy we were just talking about with his first reception of the season, Evan Drake, who is a big power forward type. That guy is a muscular dude.
Yeah, he's a big guy, and I don't really know how you can stop that. Maybe you double with Drake right there, but he shows the size there, grabs the ball, just puts the shoulder down and gets those extra 2 yards, and now two first downs on this drive.
And into Hallettsville territory at the 47-yard line. Two receivers to either side of the formation. It's a running play on first down, and it may have netted a foot, if that. Clock moving with under 9 minutes remaining here in the first quarter, and Hallettsville having already taken an early 7-0 lead.
Brings up second down and 10 for your Warriors.
Trips to the near side, one back gun, South the quarterback. Hallettsville shows blitz, and they do come. They pick it up initially. Here's the throw over the middle, intended for Strachan, and it's incomplete. Nice job by three different DBs on the Hallettsville side as they really close in on that one.
Paul, they've been watching film because if you've been watching for the first 3 weeks, Jake Strachan, this is a guy who can come up with acrobatic catches, plays in contact, and gets it batted away, third down and 10 coming up.
Excellent protection on that play, though, and that bodes well here on third and 10. South throws a screen to the far side. Stop well shy of first down yardage. They try to get the ball to Isaiah Champagne, and I will tell you, watching practice this week, they've put in a whole series of bubble and tunnel screens to Champagne.
Isaiah Champagne, a guy who can make such quick cuts. If you have a screen pass for Champagne, that's a guy who can break it open, and you could tell that was the design play from Coach Nick Rogers and his offense.
Gain of 3, so it's 4th and 7, and you don't even have to ask if Piper is going for it. Trips receivers to the near side. South awaiting the ball, looks far side, throws it, nice pitch and catch. That's the way you do that. Jake to Jake, Jake South to Jake Strachan. First down, Warriors.
Coach Rogers loves to go for it on fourth down, proves it right there. And as you hear the PA, Jake to Jake, first down there for the Warriors.
From the 35, ball on the far hash mark. Look at this stack of three receivers here on the near side. South rolls that way, now pulls up, going to be hit from behind. The ball's on the ground, and they've turned it over again. Hallettsville forces and recovers the second fumble of the night. Is the quarterback, Jake South, just blindsided from behind.
Yeah, you got to get some protection on that left side of the line. Quickly breaks on through, and Jake South hit from behind, didn't even feel it coming, and the second turnover of the quarter for this Piper offense.
Well, they take over with the ball at the 40-yard line. That fumble recovered by Jesse Cavazos. A tight end and two wide receivers to the far side. One back pistol this time. Running play on first down. That's to Sean Price, who has scored the only touchdown of the evening so far. But on this carry, he does not get back to the line of scrimmage. He lost a yard.
We've talked about already the difference in the amount of enrollment for both of these teams, a 3A versus a 5A team. But, Paul, this is a Hallettsville team who's currently ranked 8th in the state in Conference 3A.
A lot of talent. Now, keep in mind, though, they have a relatively shallow roster, and a lot of these players have to play both ways. We'll see how that impacts the ballgame going on. Safety blitz coming for the Warriors. They pick it up. Here's the pass over the middle. It goes off the hands of the intended receiver, Lane Gerke.
Brings up third down for the Braves.
That's what this Piper. I was just going to say, this is what this Piper team has to do. You got to bring pressure on a talented quarterback like this. Make him uncomfortable in the pocket and make him get the ball out quickly. And now a third and long coming up for Hallettsville.
Warriors really need a stop on this one. Safety's playing about 13 yards off the ball. Screen, far side, complete, but hit right at the line of scrimmage. Maybe a gain of two, but a nice third down stop.
Pass complete to number
applied
eight,
by Thor Michaelbust.
Michaelbust gets there so quickly. It looked like an opportunity to kind of capitalize there for Hallettsville. Michaelbust gets there in time, and a fourth down and nine, and great job by the Piper defense.
It really was. They forced a three and out after the offense committed the turnover. So Piper will get the ball back with 6:40 left in the first quarter. And the punt is away, fair catch signaled. They let it roll, and then it will be taken at about the 20-yard line.
Fair catch called by
Jackson Hopper.
13, Jackson Hopper.
And we'll keep it right here. All right, so it had to be so disheartening, Joey, for the Warriors to see the offense turn it over again, but immediately the defense responded. Not only got a stop, got a three and out.
That's already the second three and out of the ball game. This is a defense who could step up, but it's going to be the offense. We've seen that this offense can move the ball quickly, but you got to keep the ball safe if you're going to do that as well.
So the Warriors will start the drive from their 20-yard line, two receivers to either side of the formation, and it's an empty set. South rolls to the far side, his left. Now throws deep, got a man wide open. The catch is made at the 31-yard line. Spectacular catch by the senior, Nolan Doss.
Shouldn't surprise anybody. Nolan Doss always makes acrobatic plays. And a huge first down there for Piper.
That's almost a 50-yard completion.
Not to mention there's a flag as well, looking like an early jump from the Hallettsville defense. And on the free play, Jake Sell just airs it out, and Nolan Doss, the receiver that he is, makes a beautiful catch.
That's Doss's 18th reception on the season. South, on first down, steps up, throws into the end zone, over the middle, intended for Champagne, and just overthrown.
If Champagne had five more yards of the end zone, he would have made that running grab. It would have been an easy catch there. But instead, second down. But Paul, I've really liked the protection early in this ball game. Despite the fumble, the protection on the offensive line has looked pretty good.
We will follow that storyline because you are exactly right. From the one back gun, Hallettsville showing blitz. They send one inside linebacker. South, over the middle, that's Doss. And he's got another first down, down at about the 11. And again, it was good protection that allowed that route time to develop and a gain of 19 yards.
You cannot let Jake South get comfortable, because if he does, he will punish the defense, and he's proving it on this drive right here.
Drive started back at the 25. Oh. A slant over the middle to Doss, and that's a tough physical catch because he knew he was going to take a pop.
I'm glad you mentioned that, because Nolan Doss caught it, and you could tell he was bracing his body for the impact. Gets leveled on the play, but picks up 8 yards out of it.
So it's second and two from inside the five. I want to correct myself. This drive started back at the 20, not the 25. South looks near side, throws into the end zone, and it's incomplete. They were just trying to throw the alley-oop fade to Evan Drake.
Evan Drake, intended target there, not really able to turn his body quickly, but still a ball too far over his head. Third and short right here. We'll see what the design play is coming up on third and very short.
Offense looking to the near sideline to get the call from offensive coordinator Adam Arteaga. Play clock rolling with 11 seconds left. Key third down here for the Warriors, who trail 7-0. South looks into the end zone. That's easy money. That is a touchdown pass, and again, that's Jake to Jake. Jake South to Jake Stratchen. Wow, his second touchdown reception of the year. I said they made that look easy. That's an 80-yard drive, the big play being the 50-yarder from Jake South to Nolan Doss.
Yeah, and I mean, unmarked right there for Jake Stratchen. I mean, he just glided on into the end zone. And Paul, to nobody's surprise, it looks like Piper wants to go for the 2 points.
They are, and Hallettsville sees that. They call a timeout, want to make sure they've got the right personnel on the field, and we'll keep it right here. So you got to love the response there by Piper.
I said it a moment ago, this is a team who could go down the field quickly. You just got to find a way to protect the football, and they did it exactly right there. And Paul, they used basically all the receivers to get the ball down the field on that drive.
They have a lot of weapons. And they found out last week they got one more, Isaiah Champagne. There had been this disagreement as to his residence and eligibility. Piper felt very strongly that he was eligible, and they won that battle. So Champagne got in action for the first time last week. All he did was catch 7 balls for 104 yards and a TD.
Yeah, and he's already got 2 receptions in this ball game, and we're only 6 minutes into this ball game. Jake South knows he's got a really good target, and he's going to continue to use him.
All right. So the Warriors going for a 2-point conversion, which if successful would give them an 8-7 lead. Change of direction play, and that gets into the end zone. And we saw them working that play all week long. It's good for the 2-point conversion. That's Isaiah Champagne. And with that, the Warriors come back and take an 8-7 lead. 5:17 remaining in the first. Back in just a moment, right here on the Warriors Sports Network.
The Brave is 7, your Warriors 8.
Joey, Warriors take an 8-7 lead after successfully converting that 2-point play there, and the Warriors were all business on that drive.
They play fast and very fast. 6 plays, 80 yards in 1:14, and it ended on the Jake-to-Jake completion. 4-yard touchdown pass, and Piper leads 8-7.
Logan Lopez on the kickoff for the Warriors. And it's corralled there by Tanner Cliff.
Number 33, Logan Lopez.
And Hallettsville will start this drive from about their 33-yard line. As it's being put down by our referee, the crew chief, Thaddeus Chase.
First and 10, Hallettsville.
And officially it is the 33. If you think you see some big guys on that Hallettsville offensive line, you are correct. Warriors showing blitz. And we see the quarterback on the read option keep for the first time tonight. That's their really highly heralded quarterback, Jorian Wilson, 6'3", 200 pounds, brought down by Caden Glass, who comes off a spectacular defensive performance a week ago against Davenport.
Caden Glass just seems to always be in all parts of the field. The guy can defend from sideline to sideline, and he shows it right there, bringing down Wilson for the tackle.
Gain of about 4 on first down, 2nd and 6. Warriors in their standard 3-man defensive front. 3 receivers to the near side. Wilson throws it that way. It's complete to Lane Gerke, And Gerke gets first down yardage out at about the 48-yard line. They'll move the chains. Receiver knocked out of bounds by Jackson Hopper.
Jackson Hopper, another guy who can constantly get up, deflect balls. He's great in that secondary right there. Brings down the tackle with the first down just outside the 50-yard line here from Hallettsville.
Line of scrimmage, the Brahma 48. They trail by one. They scored first, took a 7-0 lead. Piper came back with an 80-yard touchdown drive and a two-point conversion, and they're on top now, 8-7. Two receivers to either side, one back pistol. Running play, and the ball carrier is stopped behind the line of scrimmage. That's going to be a gain, a loss rather, of about two. That was Deshaun Price on the carry, and he was just leveled by Leighton Lopez.
Paul Leighton Lopez just flew through that offensive line, and as soon as the running back looks up, Lopez is right in his grill, goes back for 2 yards, and a beautiful stop there by the Piper defense.
Second and 12. 4 minutes remaining here in the first quarter. Play clock at 15. Wilson awaiting the snap, pulls it out, throws play action pass near side. It is incomplete. It was intended there for Rashawn Sidney.
Play action pass there by Hallettsville, and a high throw there from Jordan Wilson. The receiver really had no option to go with that, and another third and long, and this is exactly where the Piper defense wants to force Wilson to end these drives.
Third and 12, Michael Potts checks into the ballgame defensively for the Warriors. From the 46, third and 12. Wilson will throw, goes to the far side, looking for a receiver, pulls the trigger, has an open receiver who makes the catch on his knees. We'll see where they mark the ball. That's going to be really close to first down yardage. That was Lane Gerke on the reception as he found that open dead spot in the zone, and the play does clear for the first down, so they convert on third and 12.
Yeah, third and 12 looked like a little bit of a generous spot there, but nonetheless, first down for Hallettsville. But Paul, one thing that was interesting on that play, Piper brought the pressure compared to the first three plays.
They did indeed, and Wilson rolled away from it and then got the completion for the first down. From the 43, Wilson pulls it out, hit behind the line of scrimmage, still on his feet. He's a big, strong guy, throws it to the near side, and we'll kind of see about this. There was an eligible receiver kind of over there. The pressure was applied by the fine senior defensive end for Piper, David Huntsman. Now, he was not outside the tackle box, so we might have to talk about this one a little bit.
Now, he was not in the intended target was nearby, but, I mean, he just floated that one not anywhere near a receiver, and now the official's talking about it here. Paul, as you mentioned, an interesting call coming up.
We'll see how they sort it out. We'll get the call from Thaddeus Chase.
Penalty on the play, intentional grounding.
Yeah.
By the Brahmas.
Okay, this is not just wishful thinking. This is not just a homer statement. I think they got the call right.
I think so, too. And as I was saying, the receiver was nearby, but the way he floated out, there was no chance any receiver was going to get that ball. And as a result, 10 yards backwards and a loss of a down. So second and very long for this Hallettsville offense.
Yeah, second and more than 20. And moves it all the way back to the Hallettsville 46-yard line. Exactly 3 minutes remaining in the first, and Piper leading by one at 8-7. Wilson, the quarterback. Jet sweep. They're lucky they didn't fumble that one away, but it's another big loss. What a swarm of Warriors there. Outstanding defensive play. The ball's on the ground, and this time it's Hallettsville that turns it over, and the guy that really forced that play was Leighton Lopez.
Great job there by Piper. We continue to talk about how quickly they combined together. The first fumble against Hallettsville, and it is in their own territory. First down coming up for the Warriors.
Michael Potts with some great work defensively there as well. So we'll see if the Warriors can take advantage of that turnover. They will start with excellent field position from the Hallettsville 37-yard line. Two receivers left. Two receivers right. Running back to the right of the quarterback. South steps up in the pocket, has time, lays it off on the crossing route. It's complete. That is Brady Hopper.
Flag on the play.
Looked like they're flag about 5 yards past the line of scrimmage here, and it looks like it's going to be a holding against Piper.
Yeah, there was some pressure coming off the edge. South stepped up in the pocket, but you could see that maybe a guy got grabbed just a little bit, but really a nicely designed route as the running back, Brady Hopper, was coming in that underneath drag route, but that's wiped out by the penalty, and it'll move the ball back to the Hallettsville 42-yard line, where it'll be first and 15.
Got to be a little frustrating there. It looked like South would have had enough time without that holding call. Probably could have scrambled out of the pocket. Nonetheless, first and 15 coming up.
Three receivers to the far side. South is the quarterback. Throws a slant over the middle. Complete to Strachan, who takes the ball in stride with those nice soft hands out front. And then takes the lick. But that's a meaningful gain on first down because it moves the ball to the 34-yard line. And makes this second and manageable at second and 7.
I gotta say, Jake Strachan is probably the best receiver on this team absorbing contact. I mean, he knows the contact's coming and he just absorbs it so well.
South on first down, gives it off right guard.
Hopper with the carry, takes the ball.
That's Hopper on the carry.
Close to the 30-yard line.
He gets a couple of yards, setting up a third down situation. We do have a flag on the field. Down at around the 13-yard line. We'll see what that's all about. Well, are they just picking it up? Because the play clock is running at 18, and it shows that we've got a third and 4. So never mind on the flag. Third down. They pitch it forward, so it's a completed pass, actually. Nicely designed play, and that's Brady Hopper once again.
Second time we've seen that jet sweep. The first time we saw it was on the two-point conversion. This time it goes to Brady Hopper. Gets to the edge, contact towards the end of the run, but he's able to get out of bounds for the first down.
Hopper, a big part of the game plan tonight. South on first down. Sets up, now rolls to his left, throws it into the end zone. That's a wide open receiver. And that is a Piper touchdown, and that is Nolan Goss on the reception, and that is his 7th TD catch of the young season.
Paul, I don't know how he does it. Nolan Goss, every single game, he just finds a way to be wide open in the end zone. He does it again, and the touchdown leader for this Piper team, and he does it once again.
That was a 23-yard touchdown reception, and Joey, you're right. The key so far offensively for Piper is the way they have protected their senior quarterback, Jake South. Go for it again. It's what the Warriors do. Hopper's the running back. South throws near side. Touchdown. Oh, and who is that? That wouldn't be Goss again, would it? So the Warriors now with two touchdowns and two two-point conversions on the board. And with 1:29 remaining in the quarter, the Warriors extend their lead to 16-7, back with the kickoff in just a moment here on the Warrior Sports Network.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, Ferris Orthodontics, GVTC, and Comal Independent School District.
So, Joey, the Warriors with 16 unanswered.
Yeah, another great drive from this Piper team, and they capitalize on the turnover in their own territory for the Brahmas. It ends up going 5 plays, 37 yards, 1:24, and it was capped off with a 23-yard touchdown pass to Nolan Doss, the receiving touchdown leader for this Warriors team.
So the Warriors leading by 9, set to kick it off. end-over-end kick that's going to be fair caught on the near side at about the 22-yard line by Tanner Cliff.
As the season continues to roll on, I think we're going to see a lot more of these just kind of chip kickoffs. The one struggle of this Warriors team is kickoff return. So right there, you just chip it in, and you give the ball at the 25-yard line, and you let your defense go to work.
So very effective, no question about it. And Hallisville will start this drive from their own 24-yard line. Knows the ball actually just shy of the 25.
First and 10 to the 25.
Three bunch receivers to the far side of the formation. Three-man defensive front on first down. Running play going far side. That's Deshaun Price on the carry. And he gets about three, setting up a second and seven with 1:19 remaining here in the first.
Looking like the first defender to get there was none other than Caden Glass. He just uses his body so well, slows down the running back, and allows the rest of his defense to come in and make the tackle.
On second and seven, Wilson, the big, strong, rangy quarterback. Warriors show blitz. Here they come. Oh, wow. Wilson got it away, but he also took a pretty good pop in the chest there as the Warriors brought pressure right up the middle. Incomplete pass, third and seven.
This defensive formation, usually three linebackers, but today they continue to bring more pressure. As I talked about at the beginning of this broadcast, you cannot let Wilson get comfortable in that pocket.
And that was Caden Glass on the blitz again.
Back-to-back plays where we've mentioned his name.
That happens a lot with him. He's a really fine football player. Wilson pulls the ball out, but he's going to be pulled down behind the line of scrimmage. As a matter of fact, just an overwhelming penetration that time by the Warrior defense, led by Caleb Gale.
Great job by Caleb Gale. He gets to the outside of that offensive line, quickly wraps up the quarterback by the hips and thrusts him down to the ground, and their third three and out of the ballgame for Hallettsville.
And that may have been the most impressive of the three. There was some dominance going on that time by this Piper Warrior defense. And their offense is going to get the ball back here in the waning seconds of the first quarter. Clock running with 16 showing. Low snap, rolling around. It's a loose ball. It's scooped. It's the Warriors' ball inside the 5-yard line.
Fumble snap by the Primus. Warrior football down inside the 5 at the 1-yard line.
Chris Vivians is the man who made the play for the Warriors. And what a turnaround. You know, Hallisville got the first touchdown of the night when the Warriors turned it over, but since that time, it has been all Piper.
Piper capitalizing right there, a really low snap to the punter, unable to scoop it up in time. And Vivian's, I think for a second he didn't realize the ball was on the ground, quickly scooped it up. And then the great job by special teams trying to push Vivian's into the end zone, nearly got there, stopped at the 1-yard line, but a great awareness by the special teams for this Piper team. And an explosive offense like this, Paul, they can score really quickly with just 5 seconds to go.
They're trying to set up a 1-yard touchdown drive, I know that. They've already scored 16 unanswered points, and they want to add to that. Running play, and into the end zone. That was really nicely executed. That was Brady Hopper, who takes it into the end zone as time expires here in the first quarter. So for the moment, it's 22-7. And we'll see what Coach Nick Rogers opts to do. You know what he's going to do. They've gone for two twice before. They've made it twice before. They got plenty of plays polished up. And they'll try it again.
They love to go for the two-point conversion. Went with Wildcat offense on that play. He got the ball off to Brady Hopper, and he jogged it on in.
South is the quarterback. Motion coming to the near side. Fakes it one way. Now he's going to be brought down behind the line of scrimmage. Good alert play there by Carter Blaha for Hallettsville. So the two-point conversion fails. But after one quarter, Piper has scored 22 unanswered points to take a 22-7 lead. Back with quarter number two in just a moment right here on the Warrior Sports Network.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling. The Branch Neighborhood Grill. San Martin Orthodontics. And Stratton Sport and Spa.
Well, Joey, I guess you didn't have much trouble charting that drive.
Pretty easy. One play, 1 yard, 5 second drive, and it was set up by Wildcat offense, I should say, where it was an easy grab there for Brady Hopper, and he just jogged on into the end zone, making it 22-7 as we begin quarter number two.
Well, after scoring first tonight, since that time, the Hallettsville offense hasn't done much. Here's the kickoff. It'll be fair caught at about the 28-yard line, and the Brahmas with a need to respond, trailing as they are by 15 at 22-7.
It's important to note, entering today, Hallettsville outscoring their opponents 130-8. 8 points, and it was in week number one, 22 points on the board in just quarter number one.
That says a lot, because this Hallettsville defense has been dominant through the first three games of the season.
I mean, we could say 22 points. I mean, it's looked impressive, but another thing that's really looked good, three and outs forced by this Piper defense. They've come out to play, and I really think they realize that this is going to be an explosive offense, and Hallettsville has had nothing to show in quarter number one.
While we have a moment, Hooey, the Western Action sports brand, started in Spring Branch and has been sold all over the world. Now they've opened a store in their hometown where it all began. The Hooey Community Store is just off Highway 46 next to Treehouse. Their store carries the latest styles of all types of Hooey apparel for men, women, and kids. Hats, polos, performance shirts, dresses, jeans, backpacks, and a whole lot more. Go by and visit the store when you can, and visit Hooey.com to learn more about the brand that calls Spring Branch home. So the Warriors going into this game with a record of 2-1 following that dramatic last-second victory over Davenport a week ago. This is the final non-district game for the Warriors. They'll start district play right here a week from tonight against Bastrop. Hallettsville with the football from their 35-yard line. Wilson throws near side, leads his receiver a little bit out of bounds. It was incomplete and intended there for Lane Gerke.
Gerke tried to keep his feet in bound. He would have, but the ball just gets in between his hands. And now second and 10 coming up.
Down and 10 for the Bremen.
Second and 10, line of scrimmage officially the 34. Running play near side. Deshaun Price on the carry. Guess what he can, but what he could that time wasn't much. Gain of only about two, setting up a third and long.
Price keeps his feet moving. He's very quick to cut, but this defense has just shut it down so easily. And really, the passing game has been nowhere to be seen for Hallettsville.
Pretty well non-existent. Wilson may be changing the play. Standing back at his 31. Deep ball down the far sideline, caught in stride, foot race. Receiver knocked out of bounds at the 8-yard line, but that was perfectly timed. What a great combination there, Jorian Wilson to Rashawn Sidney.
Look at some of the
Adrian Pike in defense for the Warriors.
Look at some of the highlights for Jorian Wilson. This is a guy who could step in and throw 40 yards easily. Beautiful throw right there. And now inside the red zone for Hallettsville.
First and goal on first down. Running play near side. Ball carrier cuts it back and gets his second touchdown of the night. That's Deshaun Price. And that was some nifty running at a time when Hallettsville had to have it.
They need to find a way to quickly respond to Piper, and a great cut back to the left side by Price, and he punches it in to make it a less than 10-point game.
Boy, Price really has some nifty moves and is such a hard cutter. Watch him change direction. Most impressive.
I mean, Paul, he was faced towards the right pylon, and then all of a sudden he just kind of stops, plants his foot, looks over to the left side, breaks two defenders, and jogs it on in.
We do have an injured player down on the field now being helped to his feet. And with each stride, appears to be improving, that gait getting smoother and smoother, and we'll keep it right here. The injured player is the center for Hallettsville, Brody Pathinchik. All right, so that closes the gap to 22-13. And Hallettsville has their offensive personnel on the field, so it appears they'll join the trend and go for two. Here's the attempt upcoming. Look at this formation. Just a power jumbo formation to the left side, and the big quarterback, Jorian Wilson, just ducks in behind about four guys and gets the two-pointer, and it is game on once again. Okay. 10:56 remaining before halftime, and right now, Piper leads it by a score of 22-15. We'll be back in just a moment on the Warrior Sports Network. Joey, we have seen some pretty completions already tonight, but none prettier than the one we just saw. That rainbow from Jorian Wilson to Rashawn Sidney deep down the left sideline that set up that touchdown by Hallettsville.
Yeah, Jorian Price went in a 7-yard rush, 4 plays, six yards, a minute and 4 seconds. And Paul, as you mentioned, that 57-yard touchdown pass set it up, making it 22-16 with 10:56 to go in the half.
It was a beauty.
Warriors.
Okay, so now it's the Warriors who need to respond.
The Warriors will have it first and 10 at their 25.
10:56 remaining before halftime. And we hope you'll stick around for the Ferris Orthodontics halftime show. Of course, we'll hear from the wonderful Piper Band of Warriors under the direction of Evan Berry.
If you haven't seen this Piper Band, this is a really good band. They have really great sound, probably one of the best high school sounding bands in all the San Antonio area.
It's a killer band, no question about it. Warriors from their 25. Pitch to Champagne. He's gonna lose big yardage. Back inside the 15, back to the 14-yard line. Wow, what a play. Coming up rapidly, the free safety. Just Sean Price. As I said, they got a lot of guys that go both ways.
Yeah, you mentioned that, but it's also gonna be interesting to see how that fatigue plays on these Hallettsville, both offensive and defenders, as this game continues to roll on.
Boy, that was a huge loss. A little over 10 yards. South has gone all the way at quarterback on second down, protected well again, throws it over the middle. That's Champagne, and he's got the reception and gets back the yardage that was lost on the previous play, but it's still gonna be third and about seven. With the ball out at the 28-yard line.
Isaiah Champagne said, give me the ball back. I may have lost those yards, but I'll pick him up real quickly there. 3 yards past the line of scrimmage, third and seven.
Lose 10, gain 13. Big third down play coming. South coming to the near side. Turns his hips, throws it. Lucky, was that one picked off? I was about to say he was lucky it didn't get picked off, but it was picked by Lane Gerke, who is having a tremendous first half.
Gerke doing it on both ends of the ball. Beautiful read there. He jumps in front of Isaiah Champagne, dives on the ground. Great job by the defender to put his hands underneath the ball from preventing it from hitting the turf. And this is the third turnover against the Warriors offense today.
Yeah, South just didn't get that one far enough out front, and it's difficult for a right-handed passer moving to his left on that particular throw and that particular route.
Yeah, I mean, he's thrown across his body on that one, trying to have Champagne kind of bail him out with the athleticism that Champagne has, but instead, Hallettsville has the ball in Piper territory.
At the 39, following the INT. First down running play. Lots of bodies out front of that one. That's Deshaun Price on the carry.
22 unanswered where Piper ended up scoring, and now Hallettsville trying to get those back here at a 22-16 ball game and trying to move the ball forward slowly on rushing attempts.
Second and eight. Two back gun this time. Running play, far side. Price once again.
Number 20, Price.
Going to be brought down at about the 33.
Gain of five.
So the Warriors leading by seven at 22-15 with 9 minutes remaining before halftime.
Hiram McCarter. Third down, Warriors, on your feet.
Kind of no man's land, I would expect. Probably two plays being designed right now, one for third down and one for fourth down. Really too far to kick a field goal and too close to punt it.
Play clock at nine. Two back gun. One wide receiver to the near side. Running play. Coming back to the near side and turning the corner is the ball carrier inside the 10 and into the end zone goes the man we were just talking about, Lane Gehrke. What a development.
What a game. Paul Gehrke.
It's coming back. There's a hold on the play. But
yeah,
no less a sensational effort by Gehrke.
Yeah, I was just going to say, Gehrke got the ball back for him. Despite that one going back, I mean, oh yeah, Gerke's had a great game. But good job here for Piper, as they're going to have a lot of room to work with here on third and about 13.
Yeah, very fortunate indeed for the Warriors as the ball has moved back to the Piper 43-yard line. Wilson, the quarterback, with the play clock at 10. One back pistol. Running play right up the gut by Deshaun Price. So it's going to set up a fourth down. And they're kind of in that no man's land area where you're not likely to get a whole lot accomplished with a punt here. So they'll go for it here on fourth and nine.
I'm sure they have to change up the play call, though, because on that third down and about five, you probably had a different play design. Now you got fourth and long. And now you can see everybody looking over towards the Hallettsville sideline, thinking, what play do we have set up for this type of situation?
Excellent point. So Hallettsville looking to the far sideline. And they're going to let the play clock move down to one before they call timeout. And we'll keep it right here.
And that's just one of those situations. You got to burn a timeout. You need to make sure everybody's on the same page. You're down by just one possession right here. You can't afford to give up the ball, especially with the Piper team who's so quick. So call a timeout, make sure everybody's on the same page, because as we've talked about, Hallettsville's got a lot of athletes on this team.
7:38 remaining before halftime, with the Warriors leading by seven at 22-15. So, we've seen some adjustments made. Hallettsville was having a hard time throwing the ball early in the game, but they straightened that out on that 50-yard rainbow from Wilson to Sidney that set up their most recent touchdown. And I still think that the key to the ball game so far offensively for Piper has been their ability to protect their quarterback, Jake South.
Yeah, anytime Jake South looks comfortable, he's going to punish you, and he's proved that every single time. You talk about the interception he had. He was rolling out of the pocket as soon as the play started. Protection is going to win this ball game.
Here we go, fourth and nine. Big play to say the least. Two receivers to the near side. Ball on the far hash. Wilson comes to the near side. Pressure coming up the middle. This ball's going to be picked off. What a nice play that was by Reese Madigan. But big big pressure applied on the quarterback, Jorian Wilson. He had to kind of throw it up for grabs there. And the Warriors come up with another turnover.
Yeah, great job there by Reese Madigan. He saw that ball was underthrown, goes up, grabs it. Piper inside their own 10 now, but just great job pressuring the quarterback, making Hallettsville just kind of throw that ball up there and force their second turnover of the ball game.
So the Warriors will start this drive from their own 10-yard line, leading by 7 at 22-15. Three-man defensive front. South again with time. Throws near side. Oh, he threw that ball into a small window and got it in there on the completion to Jake Strachan. And that's going to clear for the first down.
Great job there by Jake Strachan.
Yeah. And what an accurate throw, because if you miss that ball a half foot inside, that could have been a pick six.
And no, that tells me there's so much confidence right now going through Jake South's head.
On first down, South, he'll keep it this time. And the big guy gets out across the 30-yard line before he kind of niftily slides out of bounds, steps out of bounds.
Now we have second
gain of 7 yards.
At the 30-yard line.
Talked about earlier picking up yardage on first down, and to begin this drive, you had a first down completion for 12 yards and now about a 6-yard run on first down.
And that was only the sixth rush of the year by the quarterback, South. Throws again near side, Champagne on the completion. Tries to pirouette but steps out of bounds. Still, he's going to move the sticks.
That's enough yards.
First to 10 Warriors from
first
the
down.
37, 38-yard line.
Isaiah Champagne, you can see the brightness in his eyes right there. If he had a little bit more room, he would have made a nice cut there, but instead sideline was nearby, just kind of steps out, picks up the first down for the Warriors.
Trips to the far side. South, pump fake, throws deep, near side. Oh, that's Strachan. He's got it. Perfectly timed throw, just looked over his inside shoulder. He's got it. What a wonderful play. The strong safety, McCole Pagoda, tried to apply some coverage there, but Strachan just left him.
He can't apply any pressure right there. I mean, that ball was thrown on the money. It was caught in stride. Jake Strachan, if he had 5 yards of separation, he was going to the house.
All the way down to the Hallettsville 24. South, again, with lots of time. Throws it into the end zone on the corner route. We're waiting for a signal. It's incomplete. But that was quite the connection just moments ago. South to Strachan.
And Paul, there's that comfortableness in the pocket. You see, he's got plenty of time to look. And Nolan Doss, I think he had a hand in his face. That's why he didn't catch that one. But Jake South, I mean, all the time in the world, and he's having beautiful throws right now.
Second and 10 from the empty set this time. South throws a slant over the middle and overthrows his intended receiver, Strachan, who gets up hobbling just a little bit. He had to get airborne and maybe took a helmet in the thigh there, and we'll kind of keep an eye on that.
Yeah, as you said, most likely just hit in the thigh can create a little pain in the side, but hopefully he'll be able to walk it off. Third and long coming up, but Jake South continues to throw the ball for 10 yards on what seems like every single throwing attempt.
Yeah, they've been throwing the ball downfield, no question about it. Third and 10. That's a completed pass on that little shovel pass. And that's Brady Hopper, who's been used in all kinds of ways, like a Swiss Army knife tonight. And that's a really nicely designed play. And they convert on third and long, and it's going to be first and goal from the 9.
That's the third time we've seen that play, once for Isaiah Champagne, twice for Brady Hopper, and all three times, one of them has gone for 2-point conversion, and the other two have gone for 10-plus yards.
6:36 remaining in the half. Piper leading by 7 at 22-15. South, token fake. Now they throw the tone screen back inside. That was intended for Strachan, and they couldn't make connections that time.
Jake Strachan still looks a little bit slow. I'm wondering if that kind of contributed to him dropping that ball, unable to kind of turn his body quickly, and the ball goes through his fingertips, and now it's going to be second and goal.
You're right. He is still gimping a little bit. On second and goal, Strachan to the near side. South rolls to the far side, throws it near the goal line. It looks like he's got a completion to Nolan Doss down around the 1 or 2.
There was a flag at the end of that play. It looked like roughing the passer. And, I mean, the ball's going to be at the one-yard line, maybe a little closer.
We'll check out the flag.
Well, they're marking the ball inside the one.
First and goal for the Warriors.
And because there was a personal foul there, it's first down. Running play coming far side. Strachan on the carry.
Direct snap, takes the ball down to the inch line.
Can't get much closer. Right at the lip of the cup. And it'll be second and goal.
Got a note. I got a sticky note right in front of me. Paul, if you put it right in between the ball and the goal line, that's how much separation there'd be right now.
That's right. Mason Kruger checks into the ball game. And on second down.
Same play.
That's Jake Strachan getting it into the end zone. Nicely done, Warriors.
Second time today, Jake Strachan has walked into the end zone, and Piper scoring once again and continue to pour it on here in this first half.
Yeah, Hallettsville counterpunched pretty nicely there for a while, but since that time, the Warriors have reestablished control. Daniel Miranda on for the PAT, and the gentleman who kicked the winning field goal a week ago gets this conversion. And with 5:41 remaining before halftime, the Warriors extend their lead to 29-15. Back in a moment with the kickoff right here on the Warrior Sports Network. Joey, that was some nice work by the Warrior offense as they extend the Piper lead to 14.
They play fast, but it was a long drive. 11 plays for 90 yards, a minute and 50 seconds, and Jake Strachan with the one-yard touchdown run. But it was a Jake-to-Jake connection that moved the ball down the field, a 38-yard pass that moved the chains, and now the score 29-15, 5:41 to go.
And Hallettsville will start this drive from their 35-yard, where are they going to mark? About the 35 or the 34? 34 official.
34-yard line.
Brahmas break the huddle. Jorian Wilson has gone all the way at quarterback. Throws it over the middle, kind of a rainbow, and a diving attempt made. The connection not made. That was intended for Ty Tomek right up the seam.
Looks like the receiver lost the ball in the air, kind of just aired it over the middle of the field. Incompletion. Good job kind of just batting that one down to prevent one of the safeties in the secondary to avoid getting an interception.
Second and 10 following the incompletion. Two receivers to the near side from the pistol. Running play quickly into the secondary goes to Sean Price before the safeties come up to knock him down, as well as the middle linebacker, Caden Glass.
Well, it looked like a wide open gap, but all of a sudden, Caden Glass comes from nowhere, wraps up the running back, and throws him down for about a 4-yard gain.
And that could have been a lot more. Play clock at 14.
On your feet, Warriors.
Third and 6. Motion to the near side. Wilson now throws far side. It skips off the hands of the
pass
intended
falls
receiver.
Incomplete.
That was Rashawn Sidney who tried to reel it in but couldn't. And that brings up a fourth down.
I believe that's a fourth three out of this ball game for this Hallettsville offense. And as much as we've talked about the protection for Jake South, this defense has really stepped up to prevent Hallettsville from getting back in this ballgame.
A most impressive performance. So Tomek will punt it away. No, he won't, because this ball goes sailing over his head.
He's trying to get back on it, can't. This is a scoop and score. The ball is loose, and this is a Piper scoop and score. And right now it looks like that's Reese Madigan on the fumble recovery for the TD to give Piper a 3-score advantage.
A second tough snap on the punt for this Hallettsville team. Reese Madigan scoops it off the turf and jogs on into the end zone. And just like that, 35-15 in favor of the Warriors.
I like the way you put that, just like that, because that's exactly the way that happened. Here's Miranda for the PAT. It's up, it's on its way. That guy is good. And that makes our score with 4:41 remaining before halftime. Piper 36 and Hallettsville 15. Back with the final 4:41 of the half in just a moment here on the Warrior Sports Network. So the Warrior defense gets a 3-and-out. They figure they're going to get the ball back on a punt, but it gets better than that because the snapper sailed it over the punter's head, and that resulted in a direct touchdown on a scoop and score by the Warriors. And yeah, that little short kickoff is the way we're going tonight.
I think that's the direction we're going to go all season long. It has prevented these opportunities. And I mean, in the last 3 weeks, we've seen at least one kickoff return go past the 50-yard line. If you do that, it prevents the opportunity from those kind of opportunities. And honestly, it sets up, what if the kick is dropped? I mean, your special team is so close, maybe you end up getting the ball.
Absolutely. Hallettsville, trailing 36-15, gets the ball at their 40-yard line. Wilson tries to set the wide receiver screen to the far side, but that's well diagnosed by the Warrior defense. Incomplete, second and 10.
The screen pass usually allows the defense to get through, but on that play, Thor Michaelbus got through so easily, and it prevented the quarterback to really have time to think about it. And as a result, the quarterback, Jordan Wilson, just kind of had to throw quickly, and as a result, it's incomplete.
Second and 10, two-back gun, running play near side. Ball carrier gets into the secondary, finally dragged down. Once again, that's Lane Gerke on the carry, who really has been the outstanding player of the game so far for Hallettsville.
I mean, he's done it all. He's had interceptions. He's run the ball. I mean, this guy can do it all, and now sets up third and manageable for Hallettsville.
Third and 3. Clock running, 4:11 showing. Quarter number 2, three-man defensive front for the Warriors. From the two-back gun. Oh, this guy is a really big-time running back. Look at him get into the secondary and get additional yardage. Running behind his pads goes Deshaun Price, and we have two flags on the ground.
Yeah, looks like most likely going to be a face mask the way that the running back went down or possibly a holding.
Really nice balance displayed by that running back, Deshaun Price.
I mean, his cuts are just so good. He uses his body so well and able to get past the secondary and pick up those 10, 15 yards after what looked like the defense could have brought him down around the line of game.
Wow, we, with the walk-off, going to move it all the way down to the 15.
The ball down to the 15-yard line will be first and 10.
Michael Potts, big defensive lineman, checking into the ball game for the Warriors. Here on first and 10 from the 15. Brahma's trailing by 21 at 36-15. Again, from the two-back pistol. Running play near side. That's Gurky again. Talking about running behind your pads. Very low center of gravity that time.
Keeps his body low, which just works and worked behind the offensive lineman. And pretty nice gain there on that first down run.
Before the first down marker. On your feet, Warrior fans. Let your defense hear you.
Boy, the Warrior defense really needs a stop here.
Let's go.
Because if Hallettsville cuts this to a two-score game, they are right back in it, to say the least. Now, do remember that the Warriors will get the ball to start the second half.
Yeah, you get a stop right here. You just dribble out the clock and go into the half number two.
Running play. And that's his third touchdown of the night. And when I say his, I mean Deshaun Price.
Well, I don't know how you stop Price. I mean, the guy gets so low. He's able to cut so quickly. It looks like you have a chance to bring him down, and then all of a sudden you look up, and there's a white jersey sailing past.
He's got it all, including great vision.
Yeah.
He's always setting up the second tackler.
I mean, he's gone through, like, three zones already in this on each of his runs. That's usually the first defensive line and then the secondary. And then, I mean, after that, he's all alone.
Brahma's going to go for two. And that's quarterback keep all the way by Jorian Wilson. But I think they're going to mark him short. Waiting for that call to be official.
Quarterback keeper, no good.
Didn't get it. And that's quite the effort by the Warrior defense, because usually you get that big guy going behind a couple of blockers, there's nothing you can do about it. But they got the stop.
Yeah, huge stop right there. But and Piper, as a result of that one, keeps a 15-point lead, 2:33 to go. And right here, I'd like to see just run the football and just kind of end the half with this lead.
By the way, that was Caden Glass on the stop. Caden Glass again. You know, later tonight, we're going to name the offensive and defensive players of the game for the Warriors. And defensively right now, we've had a lot of great efforts, but it's Caden Glass by a secretariat margin. By a bunch of links. He's having a magnificent game.
And as I said at the beginning of this broadcast, I mean, he just finds a way to cover sideline to sideline. He's always got his body getting in front and making the tackles, and a great stop there on the two-point conversion.
So the Brahmas cut it to 36-21 with 2:33 remaining before intermission.
Real quick, Paul, 5 plays, 60 yards, 2:08, capped off by an 8-yard touchdown run for Deshaun Price, and that makes it 36-21 in favor of Piper.
Brahma set to kick it off. Ty Tomek handling the honors. Not only their kicker, but a very solid defensive player as well. And he advances on the ball, and we'll see what the Warriors can do with it. This is going to result in a touchback. So Piper will start this drive from their 25.
I'd work on the running game just a little bit right here. Just keep the ball on the ground. Maybe throw in an occasional pass or two to pick up the first down. But outside of that, just go into half and keep it 36-21. And Paul, as you mentioned, you get the ball to begin half number two.
So this will be an interesting first down call. Warriors with the benefit of a little breeze at their back here in quarter number two as they move south to north. Three-man defensive front. Slant over the middle, south to Strachan. Very close to first down yardage, and in fact, we'll have it after an 11-yard gain.
Jake to Jake,
I mean, we've just been saying that all night long, and he just continues to move the chains for Piper.
On first down, south keeps to the far side. He now pulls the trigger. Deep ball, and it falls incomplete at about the 22-yard line, intended for Champagne.
Great coverage there, rolling out to the right side. And I got to say, that's a really nice throw by Jake South on the run, able to throw that ball so deep up to Isaiah Champagne.
So, second and 10 following the incompletion. But we got a walk-off. against the Warriors. And yeah, that'll happen on a play like that. It ends up being ineligible downfield. So it remains first down. South with lots of time, throws over the middle. It's a high ball, and the receiver really takes a whack there. That's Nolan Doss, and there is a flag where that collision occurred.
Yeah, really late flag there, and I got to think it's because of the contact with the head on Nolan Doss. He was already going down, and then you see kind of a late hit towards the top of, or towards the face mask of his helmet. Luckily, he's all right with getting up after the end of the play.
Yeah, because he took a real wallop, and we'll see if this is a targeting call. Big conference going on among the officials at the 20-yard line. They're going to pick up the flag. And by the way, to me, good officiating is when the officials communicate with each other, and they got together and they said there was no violation on the play. There's nothing wrong with that. In fact, there's a lot right with that. That's the way officials are supposed to run a ball game.
Yeah, and I don't think it was intentional. Just the contact there. Luckily, the officials hashed it out there, and it's going to be second and 15 coming up.
South. This time under pressure, and throws it out on the shovel pass and gets a completion to Brady Hopper. What resourcefulness on the part of the senior quarterback, Jake South.
I don't know how Jake South found that. I mean, there was two guys in his face, and he just kind of underhand tosses it over to his receiver, and that play was dead in the waters, and now it's third and two.
And with that, the Warriors take a timeout. And we'll keep it right here. So now you got some field position, and you still have 1:42 left. So after moving that ball up out of your own end, now you are thinking points.
Yeah, you got a minute 42 to go. You got two timeouts remaining. You pick up a first down right here, and then you start to think, all right, we do have an opportunity to put to get up to above 40 points going into half number two.
You know, the addition of Isaiah Champagne to what was already an outstanding receiver core really brings a new dimension to this Piper offense.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about this being such a pass-heavy offense, and when you add in a guy like Isaiah Champagne who can make cuts, a beautiful route runner, it just makes his team so much more dangerous. You got Jake Strachan who can catch any ball in contact the seam. Nolan Doss, a guy who's always open somehow. And then now Isaiah Champagne. I mean, there's weapons all around this offense.
Third and two. From the one back gun. South, pump fake, throws deep, far side, got a man wide open, got a completion inside the 20, inside the 15, and down to the 11-yard line. And that's that man, Nolan Doss, the deep ball captain. Already has a touchdown reception tonight. He's caught 7 TD throws on the year, and he got himself wide open.
Less than 30 seconds ago, I was just talking about he's the guy who's always open, and he does it once again, and then a beautiful cut to put this ball inside the 15-yard line.
Gain of 45. South from the empty set. This time throws it near the goal line, waiting for a signal. That's a touchdown. What a job of keeping that play alive by the quarterback, Jake South.
Beautiful pass once again in contact. Ends up going in 42-21 now the score with a minute and 15, and Piper is firing on all cylinders right now.
Remember the big guy we were talking about early in the game, that receiver, that big muscular power forward receiver, Evan Drake? That was him.
His second reception in the ball game. Why not make it a touchdown? And Piper just continues to roll on.
Logan Lopez with the PAT. And what an outstanding response by the Piper offense as they extend their lead now to 43-21.
The score, Grambis 21.
Paul, I just got to say, this is giving me flashbacks of the Leander-Glenn game, week one, around 40 points, also going into halftime, Piper's offense. And one thing that was important about that game is Jake South was so comfortable in the pocket that day.
It's very true.
And I mean, he's
like, very true.
I mean, he's just so relaxed, and if you let that, he can step into his throws, and he buys so much time for his receivers to go down the field.
He is a big, strong guy. And by the way, I didn't get a chance to mention this last week because that game against Davenport got so crazy down the stretch. But this week, Piper players Jake South and Caden Glass have received offers, football scholarship offers, to attend Texas Lutheran.
Yeah, congratulations to that man. Well deserved. And have you been watching through the first 4 weeks, you can see why those offers are on the table.
Still 1:15 remaining before halftime, and here's the kickoff. Taken at the 25, advanced outside the 35, and brought down at about the 38-yard line.
They took the ball out to around the 38-yard line.
So 43-21 with a minute and 9 to go. And if you're the Talisville team, you got to find a way to at least put 3 points on the board. You cannot afford to go down to the half like this, especially with how well the Piper defense has played in this ballgame.
By the way, this is a Brahma defense that had been giving up less than 3 points a game and had pitched two consecutive shutouts, and they've allowed 43 points here in the first half. Not all the result of their defense, however. Running play near side. Nifty open field tackle made at the 35-yard line.
Brought down behind the line of scrimmage by number 2, Jordan Grant.
Jordan Grant gets credit for that fine defensive play that results in a loss of almost 2. Moves the ball back to the 36-yard line.
Another storyline of this game, Hallettsville continuing to kind of play behind the chains, especially on second downs, and it's just been those rushing plays that have continued to go behind the line of scrimmage.
Wow, that man can break tackles. He can stay on his feet. He is still on his feet, and he's still got it going on. I'm talking about Deshaun Price. Finally brought down by a defensive lineman. What a great job in pursuit by David Huntsman.
I mean, the guy just finds a way to bounce off defenders and keep his feet moving for first downs.
Motion and a whistle before the snap.
16 seconds on the clock. Ball has been down. Second down for the Brahmas. They're at the 34-yard line.
Jorion Wilson just going for the spike there, just trying to slow down the ball game. As I mentioned, at least you got to find a way to get a field goal going into halftime.
Second and 10. Wilson wants to throw under pressure, takes a shot, throws it over the middle. Ball a little too far upstairs and falls incomplete.
10
intended for Lane Gerke.
Third and long for the Brahmas.
You know, and
let's
even though
Warrior
the Warriors have 43 points on the board, this is an important stop right here for the Warrior defense.
Yeah, you get the ball to begin half number 2. And one thing that's been interesting in this ball game, pressure, pressure, pressure. They continue to do it. Thora Michaelbuss got through the offensive line and brought the hit on the quarterback on the last play.
On third and a full 10. Wilson under pressure, throws over the middle, overthrows his intended receiver, and the clock stops with four seconds showing.
Despite that ball not being on target, I'm still really impressed the way the quarterback's able to step into that ball despite the pocket literally collapsing on top of him on that play.
Yeah, that Warrior pass rush is getting home, as they say. And Wilson has taken some real shots to the midsection. Here on fourth and 10, with 4 seconds showing in the half. Wilson throws deep, far side into double coverage. The ball leads the receiver out of bounds, and that is the final play of the first half. And what a display on both sides of the ball for these Piper Warriors. And they go into the locker room at halftime leading 43-21 in this final non-district tune-up for the Warriors. Wow, what a half. We hope you'll stick around for the Ferris Orthodontics Halftime Show coming up in just a moment right here on the Warrior Sports Network. I am so glad they didn't score. We'll be right back.
Hey, I got another one for you. And just look at the hole in this line. You could drive a truck right through there. I mean, the refrigerator William Perry could get a first down there. But you know who's going to get their number called for this one? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Ferris. He's like a ligating linebacker. Boom, just like that. And that's why Ferris Orthodontics is going to get the MVP for this one.
Got the tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Fun part of being a dad, but I have to speak to you about something that is concerning me.
Concerning you?
Yeah. Heard you and your mother talking about this Arlo fella, and
Arlo?
I wasn't eavesdropping. He's always watching you. His videos are secure. This guy sounds like a creep.
It's not.
Your privacy is very important to me, and I think you need to make better decisions when it comes to boys. And this Arlo is not a boy that I think you should be dating.
You're dating someone?
Yeah, Arlo. I heard you guys talking about him.
Arlo?
Yeah.
Dad, Arlo's the name of the new security cameras that we got from our service provider. We were talking about how great they are and how safe they make me feel. Arlo's not a boy.
Well, that's a boy's name.
Oh, boy.
Not a boy. Apparently, we just learned that. It's a camera named after a boy. Why don't you name it Peter?
Oh man, here's a broken play. I don't think any of these guys are north to south runners. I mean, look at this one here. Just bounced outside with no blockers ahead of him. But you know, you can always call a Hail Mary, and the guy that you want as your QB is Dr. Ferris. I mean, you give Dr. Ferris the ball, and boom, good things happen. Yep, that's Ferris Orthodontics again with that really nice new smile.
Hey, buddy. Got your glove?
Yep, I got it right here. You're coming, right?
Of course. I'll see you in 10 minutes.
Awesome.
Don't forget the you-know-whats.
Whether you're gearing up for a big project or a big game, GVTC has everything you need to stay connected.
What do you think?
They are going to love these.
From smart security and high-speed internet to TV and phone, GVTC provides cutting-edge technology for your home and business.
Thank you.
You made it.
Hey, what is it?
Whoa, jersey! Yes.
With deep roots in the community, we're committed to building a stronger, better, connected future for the areas we serve. Our GVTC Foundation's charitable support and industry-leading products help you stay connected to what matters most. GVTC, connecting you.
Thank you.
Oh, man, here's a broken play. I don't think any of these guys are north to south runners. I mean, look at this one here. Just bounced outside with no blockers ahead of him. But you know, you can always call a Hail Mary, and the guy that you want as your QB is Dr. Ferris. I mean, you give Dr. Ferris the ball, and boom, good things happen. Yep, that's Ferris Orthodontics again with that really nice new smile.
So, where are we eating?
With GVTC's blazing fast fiber speeds.
3.5 stars, not a chance we try anything under 4.
You might feel like other things in life are taking a little longer than before.
Ooh, what sounds better, La Fiesta or Dumpling Palace?
Ooh, Dumpling Palace.
Ew, gross.
We may not be able to speed up your dinner decisions, but we can provide fast and consistent premium Wi-Fi to search all the available options. Enjoy the GVTC difference, and please be patient with things that may have seemed to...
Wait, what are we gonna watch?
Slow down a bit. GVTC, connecting you.
I got another one for you. And just look at the hole in this line. You could drive a truck right through there. I mean, the refrigerator William Perry could get a first down there. But you know who's going to get their number called for this one? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Ferris. He's like a ligating linebacker. Boom, just like that. And that's why Ferris Orthodontics is going to get the MVP for this one.
Tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright terrifying. GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Back at halftime at Warrior Stadium. Piper in the lead at halftime over Hallettsville, 43-21. Anytime you come to a Piper football game, one of the real treats is this wonderful band of Warriors under the direction of Evan Berry. We'll just throw it down there and catch some of this.
Piper High School Band of Warriors.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, Ferris Orthodontics, GVTC, and Comal Independent School District.
Hey, I got another one for you. And just look at the hole in this line. You could drive a truck right through there. I mean, the refrigerator William Perry could get a first down there. But you know who's going to get their number called for this one? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Ferris. He's like a ligating linebacker. Boom, just like that. And that's why Ferris Orthodontics is going to get the MVP for this one.
Tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. Because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, The Branch Neighborhood Grill, San Martin Orthodontics, and Stratton Sport and Spa.
Back at halftime at Warrior Stadium, we've played 24 minutes, and our score after the first half, Piper leads Hallettsville 43-21. We hope you enjoyed the Ferris Orthodontics halftime show, another great performance by that Piper band of Warriors under the direction of Evan Berry. And Joey, you know, Hallettsville scored first, and then Piper comes back with 22 unanswered, looks to be taking control. Hallettsville kind of gets back into it. They get a couple of big passing plays from their quarterback, Jorian Wilson, but most of all, they got some remarkable runs by Deshaun Price. But every single time Hallettsville responded, the Warriors really counterpunched. They've stretched this out to 43-21. I think that was a big stop they got right before halftime, and Piper gets the ball to start the second half.
Yeah, that was a huge stop on defense to get to keep the score 43-21. And then talk about the offensive side of the ball, Paul. The major story of this ball game has been the protection. You give Jake South that much time, he's going to make you pay. And, I mean, he's got so many weapons, as we've talked about, Isaiah Champagne, Jake Stratton, along with Nolan Doss. I mean, the names are endless, and Jake South looks comfortable, and Piper right now comfortable, but they can't be. They got to continue to play in half number two.
You know, it's interesting. This week in practice, pass protection was a major point of emphasis.
Mm-hmm. I mean, the last 2 weeks, the Davenport and then Wimberly, they both realized that if you pressure Jake South, make him uncomfortable, he's gonna struggle to make plays, and that's exactly what the last 2 weeks was. But this week, Hallettsville has allowed time for Jake South, and it looks very similar to the game that we saw in week one against Glenn.
Jake South has just been excellent offensively. Defensively, we've had some big-time players. Caden Glass with another big half. And don't forget, Reese Madigan not only had an interception, but he also had a special teams scoop and score there. So he's having a big game. And we don't want to short this guy at all. I'm talking about a member of the Hallettsville Brahma team. Lane Gerke, number five, their senior, is just a fabulous two-way player. He has had spectacular plays on both sides of the ball.
Fabulous is a perfect word to describe it. The guy has been everywhere. We talk about the interception he's had earlier. Offensively, he's produced for Hallettsville. And if you're a coach, I mean, nothing's better than a guy that can play both sides of the ball. And not only that, he plays it at such a high level.
I think I've got it figured out what the real charm is for the Warriors tonight. It's the white pants. First time all year they've gone with the white pants, and it's going well.
The white pants, I mean, it goes perfectly with the purple and then the gold helmets. Just love the colors here for the Piper High School.
See, coaches are like that. I spent some time in coaching. And, you know, there's a difference between causation and correlation. Doesn't matter. You know, if we're wearing white pants for the first time and we're doing this, we're going to wear white pants a lot.
I mean, they've produced at such a high level. We still got 24 minutes of football to play, and they're playing at such a high level. Excited for 24 minutes of football.
Well, I'm up for it. How about you?
Pumped. Cannot wait here for week four.
Oh, yes, indeed. All right, as we mentioned, Piper, which leads at 43-21, will get the football. And that's Ty Tomek, who has teed up the football at the 40 on the near hash. And here we go, quarter number three. It's kicked along the ground and is going to go out of bounds. You're not supposed to do that. So Piper will get good field position with which to start this drive.
You know, one thing I was just thinking as soon as the ball was getting ready to be kicked off, we talked about how important that stop was going into the end of half number one. But think about how important it will be if Piper can go down and score 7 points. I mean, you can completely take the air out of the balloon on the other side of the field, and I think it would be crucial for them to score 7 points right here.
Yeah, because, you know, you just don't get that many possessions in a half. So if they stretch it out like that, Hallettsville would really be behind the eight ball. From 30, empty set this time with three receivers to the far side. South looks that direction, pulls it down, now throws it, and it sails out of bounds. Nearest receiver was Strachan.
That was a good job there by Jake South. Realizes the pocket's collapsing, rolls out to his left side. Nobody's really open down the field, so just kind of tosses it out of bounds and setting up the second down and 10 rather than losing yardage.
Three receivers to the far side. Three-man defensive front. Hallettsville showing blitz. Here they come. Pass play complete. Doss, first down.
Heavy hit at the end of that play, but Nolan Doss open once again, picks up 10 yards. Ball, I just don't understand how Nolan Doss, I mean, every time he catches the ball, there's 10 yards of separation from him.
Two things. He's really good as a route runner, but these plays are so beautifully designed. They get him open and they throw him open.
And he capitalizes every single time on those plays.
He does. First and 10 from the 41. South, again with time. Deep ball, near sideline. Doss, the intended receiver, again. Did he get a foot down? Did he really? They're going to say he did. That is a remarkable catch. Are they going to bring it back? Okay. It was still a pretty good catch, don't you agree?
It was a really nice grab. Right. But just unable to keep that back foot and slide it on the turf. But, I mean, it just shows Nolan Doss. I mean, just the acrobats that he can make and the vision that he has to see that ball come down from the night sky.
Almost. Second and 10. South comes to the near side. Now throws it. This one's complete. That's Mr. Champagne.
Nice option there. And one thing I've noticed, especially the last about quarter and a half from Jake South, he keeps doing that fake toss, and it fooled everybody on the defensive line for Hallettsville in that play.
Nicely done. Now they balance the formation. Two receivers left, two receivers right. Here on third and just shy of 5 yards to go. South throws over the middle, complete Champagne. Look, watch the way he just snatches that ball out of the air. He is such a smooth athlete.
I mean, the ball is just vacuumed in, and it almost seems like he gets the ball on a kind of a high toss, and it makes it look like the ball was right at his chest, able to capitalize, and then Champagne picks up an extra 5 yards off of it.
Tackle made by the safety, Lane Gerke, who's been everywhere on both sides of the ball for Hallettsville tonight. First down from the 41. Three receivers right. Empty set. No, actually it was a one-back gun. Deep ball, left side, intended for Strachan, incomplete, but we do have a flag. But we do have a flag at about the 20-yard line.
Yeah, mostly going to be pass interference. As soon as the contact was made, Strachan lifts his hands up, and that's when the flag was thrown.
Yeah, they're going to get Rashawn Sidney for P.I. This drive's a big deal. Right now the margin is 43-21. You stick 7 or 8 on top of that, and Hallettsville is really in a hole. South, again, wants to throw left side into the end zone. We're awaiting a signal. And there it is. That's a touchdown.
There it is.
There we go.
Yeah, Jake to
South
Jake.
South to Strachan.
Just once again, and you know what made that play possible? The offensive line bought so much time for Jake South. I mean, he was just there. Feet were planted. Throws a perfect dime into the end zone, and Jake Strachan hauls it in.
26 yards on the TD pass. That's South's fourth touchdown pass of the night. He now has 13 on the season. Strachan will hold. There's Miranda with the kick, and he puts it through, and that is a very significant score because that extends the lead to 50-21. 10:45 remaining here in the third quarter. Back in just a moment, right here on the Warrior Sports Network.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, Ferris Orthodontics, GVTC, and Comal Independent School District.
Seventy yards on that latest Warrior touchdown drive. Joey, tell us more about it.
Six plays, 70 yards, and 1:15. The team plays fast, and they continue to prove it. 26-yard touchdown pass, and it was a Jake-to-Jake connection once again to make it 50 pieces on the board, 50-21, but 10:45 to go in the third.
Lopez kicks it off, and there's a scrum down there at about the 38-yard line. It's the Hallettsville offense that's been averaging going into this game 43 points per game.
And then, as you mentioned, what was it, three? Averaging three allowed points a game?
Well, I mean, actually, slightly less than three.
Slightly less?
Yeah.
Just a completely different game than what Hallettsville is used to. And here in week four, kind of an eye-opener as they get ready to go into district.
So Hallettsville trailing 50-21 here in the opening moments of the third quarter. We'll start this possession from their own 42-yard line. Jorian Wilson has gone all the way at quarterback for Hallettsville and has provided some big plays. On first down, it's a running play. That's been their most productive offensive player of the night. That's the running back, Deshaun Price. He got a gain of about three on first down. It's second and seven.
McCarter came in for the tackle on that play. And with the running back who's so elusive, like Deshaun Price, you just want to combine and make the tackle as quick as possible and minimize the yards gained.
The carry moves the ball out to the 45-yard line. Warriors in their standard three-man defensive front. That's the quarterback, Wilson. A big, strong, powerful young man. But he's still about 2.5 yards shy of the first down. And it's third down with the ball squarely at midfield.
Yeah, Wilson, tall, strong, uses his body to his advantage to extend on that play. But Paul, as you mentioned, about 2 yards short here on this third down try.
Warriors show blitz. Here they come. Wilson rolls away from it, throws the ball on the far sideline. Pass falls incomplete, and it's going to be fourth down.
Yeah, I'm glad you mentioned that blitz. Caden Glass just flew through the offensive line, forced Wilson to roll out to his right side, throw the incomplete pass, and now fourth and short, ball right at midfield. Another opportunity for a big stop for this Piper defense.
Thor Michael Bust checks into the game defensively for the Warriors on fourth and two. Running play near the sticks. This is going to depend on the spot.
I don't think he's going to get it.
He looks like he's short from here. He's just into Warrior territory. But a nice play made by Jackson Hopper defensively, along with that man, Caden Glass, once again. Ball goes over.
Great job by those two to use their body to prevent Wilson from getting that extra stretch. We talked about his height. We talked about his weight. This is a guy who can use his body to stretch forward, and Piper putting their bodies on the line to get the ball back to the offense just a yard short of Hallettsville territory.
This has been a very physical performance by these Warriors tonight. They'll start this drive at their own 49, leading 50-21. South rolls to his left, he was outside the tackle box, and there was somebody kind of sort of standing around there, so that'll be all right, I think. We do have an injured player for Hallettsville.
Looks like just some cramping, hopefully.
I sure hope so. It kind of looks that way, yeah. So the second half, Joey, has begun exactly the way the Warriors wanted it to. And really it started with that stop right before halftime.
Yeah, that stop and then coming out to score. I mean, Piper has done every single thing that they could have done right, they've done right in this ball game. And you got to think, this is such a relief going into district play, knowing that this team has already had two performances like this season where they put up 50 or more.
Okay. I hope this isn't the announcer jinx at all with Piper leading 50-21. But if it stays this way, this would be Piper's first ever varsity victory on this field.
And that's gotta feel great. We talk about this is the first year having seniors. It's just gotta feel great. We've talked about the development of these students going through the hallways, and now to be able to win your first varsity game on home turf, that's what starts to create that winning mentality here at Piper High School.
By the way, the player that's walking off with that cramp is Deshaun Price, who's both a running back and a defender and has been by far one of their best players tonight, along with the performance that's been turned in by Lane Gerke. First and 10 for the Warriors. South moves through the rush, now throws, had an open receiver at the 30-yard line and a misconnection there with Jake Stratton.
Good job there by Jake South to just kind of weave through the defenders coming to go for the sack. He gets on through, throws a pass down the field, unfortunately incomplete, but just great vision looking down the field and avoiding the sack.
Third and 10 from the Warrior 49-yard line. South to his left, flips it out, complete to Doss. He gets it into Hallettsville territory, short of the first down, and there is a flag on the play.
Say a flag just past the line of scrimmage.
Hilly's against the Warriors. That'll back us up.
So the line of scrimmage was the Warrior 49. That's a big old walk-off all the way back to the 34-yard line.
Yeah.
Where it remains third down.
Huge walk-off there.
South throws near sideline, looking for Drake. He's got it, and the big guy made a play all the way down to the 15-yard line. I have so much been waiting for this guy to break loose. You see him in practice. I'm talking about this big, rangy receiver, Evan Drake. He is so physical, and he's having a night.
Yeah, we talked about Evan Drake. We wanted to see him more involved, and he just took the ball straight out of the defender's hands, stole it right off of him, and goes for an extra 15 yards. And if there wasn't one extra help, he would have gone in for 7 points.
41 yards on the connection. So the Warriors come up with that big play on that long yardage situation. They got a first and 10 from the Hallettsville 15. And you mentioned this earlier toward the beginning of the ball game, Joey. Got so much respect for these Hallettsville athletes and the caliber of athletes they have, but they're not real deep, and a lot of players have to go both ways, and we are now seeing the effects of that.
Yeah, and especially as the season rolls on, I mean, it takes a lot of hydration to be able to play the full 48 minutes, but no matter what, I mean, if you're playing two sides of the ball, you're playing nearly 48 minutes of real game time, and that's not even excluding the real time that goes beyond. And I mean, you just look at the different benches right here, and you see all the purple jerseys and the handful of Hallettsville jerseys on the other side of the field.
That depth is a factor. So this is the final non-district game for the Warriors. They'll open up league play a week from tonight right here against Bastrop. Hallettsville, which goes into this game 3-0, will play at Central Catholic next week.
That should be a pretty interesting game too. Central Catholic, a team who has been good past couple of years. That will be another pretty nice test for Hallettsville going forward.
Yes, it will. The Hallettsville coach, Levi Montgomery, has really done a wonderful job with this program. The player going off to the far side of the field for Hallettsville is Tanner Cliff. And that looks like it may be a case of cramps as well.
Always glad to see the guys walking off under their own power, and appears to be so as he walks back towards the Hallettsville bench.
First down from the 15. Three receivers to the far side. Drake is that big receiver to the near side. South looks his way first, now throws it the other direction. Got a man open. He got another touchdown pass. And I think that's your man, Nolan Doss, once again.
Nolan Doss, you talked about a moment ago. This is a guy who's a great route runner. He cut to the right, and then he had another cut left, which is designed by the route, and as a result, loses the defender. And Nolan Doss wide open in the end zone, right at the W on the Warriors end zone. And another 6 points for the Warriors, and another touchdown to add to the resume of Nolan Doss.
Nolan Doss padding that resume for sure, and Jake South with his fifth touchdown pass of the evening. And he now has 14 on the season. PAT is on its way and good. And with that, the Warriors extend their lead to 57-21 with just over 8 minutes remaining in the third. We'll be back with the kickoff in just a moment here on the Warrior Sports Network. So he's got back at Warrior Stadium, stars galore for the Piper Warriors. Nolan Doss with his second touchdown reception of the evening. Jake South has thrown 5 touchdown passes. And this one is getting blown open now with Piper leading Hallettsville 57-21. Fair catch made on the kickoff at about the 26-yard line.
So here we go. Hallettsville will get the ball, but not after 5 plays, 51-yard drive, 49 seconds, capped off by the second receiving touchdown on the night for Nolan Doss. It's a 15-yard pass from Jake South, but not to mention the 41-yard pass to Drake. And, Paul, Drake just continues to play well in this ball game as well.
So look at the contributions they're getting now from Champagne and Drake, adding to what they already had. This team could get scary.
As the weeks go on, it's just the weapons that we name continues to grow week by week.
Ball just outside the 25. Running play on first down, straight up the gut, gain of only 2.
Short gain on the play by the Bramers. Brought down by that defensive front.
Despite the score, though, you got to give credit to Deshaun Price. I mean, this is a guy who just has ran the ball so well, has found the end zone multiple times, and Ian Price has been a really impressive running back for this Hallettsville team.
They give him 3 yards on the carry, so it's 2nd and 7. Ball just shy of the 29-yard line. Ball thrown to the near side and incomplete. The intended receiver was Jesse Cavazos.
Cavazos just juggling that ball, was unable to ever fully haul it in. Thought he had it for a second, bounced off the pads on the thighs and ends up ricocheting out. 3rd and 7 coming up here for the Brahmas.
So Cavazos and Pagoda are the two receivers to the near side of the field. Pagoda goes in motion. He's got the football on the jet sweep, and he's about 4 yards shy of a first down. Clock moving, 7:11 remaining in quarter number 3.
Let's say another 3 and out. I believe that's the 5th of the ball game for this Hallettsville team, and this defense just has been so impressive tonight. I would like to say that I would probably credit this as one of their best defensive games of the season.
Amen on that. Here's the punt. It's a good one. Wow, inside the 5 and into the end zone. So they catch a little bit of a break there as Jackson Hopper, the deep return man, really had no choice but to kind of watch that one. But it does go into the end zone for the touchback. And the Warriors will get the football.
What a punt there from Hallettsville. We've talked about needing to pin them back, and Hallettsville, a massive punt all the way from the 30-yard line, ends up being a touchback for Piper. And now this offense gets the ball, and we'll see if, as this game continues to come to a close, is Piper going to go a little bit more conservative, just trying to run out the clock, or are they going to continue to find the end zone?
That was a lengthy putt, and there is a big breeze blowing there. Jake Strachan now playing quarterback, something he does very well. He'll give it off on first down. Running play coming near side. Across the 20-yard line goes John Hamilton.
Flag on the play. Great run by,
and there is a flag
one
on the play.
John
and
Hamilton.
That collision may have happened a little too far outside the white.
And Hamilton was already out of bounds, got a little shove, and ended up running into one of the athletic trainers. It looked like everybody is all right. And as a result, first down for the Warriors. So we mentioned Jake Stratchin, now a quarterback. You may see, well, he's one of the best receivers, but entering week one, this was actually the quarterback talk, who would take the starting reins at that quarterback position.
Understand, he is a great quarterback. Stratchin wants to throw, throws the screen. It was intended for Hamilton. A lot of traffic over there defensively.
Look like a little screen pass set up there. Just unable to make a play as Jake Stratchin just ended up throwing that ball off his back foot, really unable to buy enough time to find a receiver open.
Second and 10, trips to the far side. Stratchin throws near side, and it was intended for the outstanding senior receiver, Nathan Martinez. Had a lot of mustard on that one, kind of got through his hands.
That's another receiver that could prove to be a weapon later down the road. We've already mentioned all the other guys, but if Nathan Martinez could be another receiver as well, I mean, who do you guard at that point with that many receivers?
Martinez is really good, and yeah. I'm waiting for him to go off.
And, I mean, Drake, today was Drake's days. You never know. Maybe Martinez's week is next week.
Could well happen. Third down. Stratchin steps up. Oh, got a man wide open. That's Hamilton. First down, inside the 20, heading for the goal line, inside the 10, pulled down at the 7-yard line. Good job of keeping the play alive by Stratchin. An outstanding effort by John Hamilton. Finally pulled down by Rashawn Sidney.
Great discipline there by Jake Stratchin. He could have ran that ball for a first down, and instead he uses patience as a quarterback, finds his receiver, John Hamilton, open, and then Hamilton goes to work, cut left, breaks two defenders, and he was off to the races. A nice save there by the Hallettsville defender, able to catch up to John Hamilton, but now first and goal coming up for the Warriors.
40 yards on the play. First and goal from the 8. Warriors trying to add to their 57-21 lead. Motion across the formation. Stratchin, shovel pass underneath. That's Hamilton again inside the 5 down to the 4. Okay, if you recall back in week 1, the Warriors scored 62 points. They've got 57 on the board with still 5 minutes to go in the third quarter.
Yeah, we still got another 12 minutes after this. No doubt that Piper can pass that up. And if we thought week 1 was good, wow, week 4 has been amazing.
Very solid effort by pretty much everybody. Two receivers to either side. Stratchin gives it to Hamilton. He sees that goal line, and he crosses it. And that's 6 more points for the Piper Warriors.
For a Warrior touchdown!
Paul, I'm glad you mentioned everybody has played good. Offense, defense, and special teams.
And special teams, absolutely.
I mean, talk about Reese Madigan with the scoop and score. They also forced a turnover inside the 15-yard line. Special teams, kind of a forgotten part of the team sometimes, and they are the ones that can help you reach that championship level.
Well, special teams on a roll now for the Warriors. Remember, they got the win on that big field goal on the last play of the game last week at Davenport. So this is now officially the most points scored in a game by the Warriors so far this year. Of course, this is only game number 4. They scored 62 in the opener in that victory over Leander Glenn, and they've got 63 posted tonight with just under 5 minutes remaining in the third.
May only be the fourth game of the season, but I'm going to go out and say it's going to be tough to beat this one. I mean, it's tough to just put over 50 in. Piper's been firing all cylinders today.
Unfortunately, got a personal foul against the Warriors. Moves it back to the 18-yard line. Jaden LeGrand in the ballgame at wide receiver for the Warriors, who take a timeout. Actually, I think it was taken by Hallettsville. What a performance. And you have to keep in mind how talented this Hallettsville team is. I mean, getting a lot of statewide attention.
Yeah, I mean, talked about earlier, eighth in Conference 3A Division 1, a team who is known as one of the top teams in 3A football, and they're competing with big-name schools like that at Central Catholic, and dominant performances 46-0 against Van Fleck last Friday night. So this is a Hallettsville team who knows how to play football, but this is a Piper team who's going all together, getting ready to go into district, and you got to think this is going to be huge going into this week as you get ready to prepare for first district opponent in 2023.
Warriors had an excellent week of practice. Stratching the quarterback, token fake, throws it into the end zone, near side. That's Martinez trying to make the diving catch, can't quite come up with it. So the score holds at 63-21.
So here we are with 4:45 to go.
I'm wondering what they're trying to sort out here. Must have been a flag on Hallettsville, so we'll have a redo, this time from the 18-yard line. Strachan crosses the line of scrimmage. It's all yours now, buddy. Turns the corner at the 10. That's as far as he could take it, though.
Takes the ball all the way down to the 7-yard line.
And it looks like they just put up fourth down, and I'm wondering if they called back that touchdown because that incomplete pass happened. Yeah, they just took off the points off the board.
They took the points off the board. Okay, the reason there was a question here is because they hadn't taken the points off the board. It said 63, but that's exactly what happened here. So we got a reset here. The score is 57-21. And this will be a field goal effort with the ball placed at the 15-yard line, so a 25-yard field goal attempt. And this one is pushed wide right. So some weirdness there. We appeared to have the touchdown by Hamilton. There was a penalty there. They put the points on the board. They didn't take the points off the board. So with that, they roll it back. First time I've seen that happen. So at the moment, this is not the most points scored by Piper so far this year, but it is 57-21 as they turn it over after the missed field goal.
That's a unique sequence of plays there as everything gets sorted out. But Paul, as he mentioned, still second most points scored in a game this year, but you still got over 15 minutes to go in this ball game. Wouldn't be surprised if Piper can find a way to score those 62 plus.
Hallettsville trying to get some momentum for next week. They take the ball at their 20-yard line. Running play off right guard. And that's Traydon Williams, number 28 in the ball game for the Brahmins.
Important to note for Hallettsville, two non-district games left. You got Central Catholic on the 22nd, and then Cypress Christian out of Houston on September 29th before beginning district play October 6th at Columbus High School.
They are a good football team, and they have a lot to look forward to this year. That was a gain of three, so it's second and seven with the ball placed at the just shy of the 23. Ball carrier hit behind the line of scrimmage, kicks out of one tackle. It gets buried by three more defenders. Great team defense by the Warriors. Gage Norris, first man of the ball carrier.
Yeah, you talk about Norris getting there quickly, but then it's a combination. Combinations is just something we've talked about all season long, and that is how they work so well to bring down these running backs and makes it a loss of a yard.
Full nine needed. Running play coming near side. Gain of only about two. Joey, I'm wondering, are you a little surprised we haven't seen more running from the quarterback, Jorian Wilson, tonight?
Yeah, I mean, he's an athletic guy. We talked about his baseball skills, his football skills. But, I mean, really, he's just been handing the football off to Deshaun Price. And whenever the quarterback has gone for the runs, he's used his body well to extend.
Let's go, Warrior
and
fans.
It's, yeah, to answer your question, Paul, it just seems like he's hasn't used as much. And really, we haven't gotten to see his arm as well as we thought we would today.
Very true, except for one long play. Here's the punt. It's away cleanly. The last punt was a great one. This is pretty good. Hopper will take it back at his 34-yard line and return it to the middle of the field, and it's stopped at the Piper 49.
That's 1 yard outside of Hallettsville territory. And with 2:09 to go, interesting to see. I would like to see Coach Rogers use the run game a little bit more. I think that's an area of improvement you want to work on going into the future. So how can you get your running game going a little bit more going into future games?
Well, we got a new running back in the ball game. It's Samuel Campos, the junior. And as Joey indicated, the Warriors start this drive from their own 49, leading 57-21. And there's the man we were just talking about, Samuel Campos on the carry.
Number 20, Samuel Campos. That's good enough for a Warrior first down.
We talked about Campos not playing very much, and he gets his first handoff entry today, 15 rushes for 36 yards, and he picks up, 12 yards on that rush?
I think it was more like 16, right?
Yeah.
Yeah. Moves the ball to the 35-yard line. Play clock at 14. Two receivers each direction, stretching the quarterback. Gives it off to Campos, who this time doesn't get back to the line of scrimmage and, in fact, loses almost three.
That's what I was talking about, though, just liking to see that the running backs can do. How are they going to how can they adapt on certain plays? I mean, you talk about that 16-yard pickup, then a loss. How can your running backs respond to any sort of position that you set them up in any side of the field?
Warriors bleeding a little clock here. Game clock at 47 seconds, play clock at 4. Campos right up the middle, inside the 30, down close to the 25.
Campos again with the carry, takes the ball all the way down to the 20.
That's two good rushes here from Campos. Two out of his three rushes have gone for 10 or more yards already, and maybe Campos starts to get a little bit more hand, a little bit more touches going forward.
Good-looking player. Sets up a third and one situation with the ball at the 26-yard line. Clock running with 10 seconds remaining in the quarter. And this will, in fact, be the final play of the third quarter. We've played three here at Warrior Stadium. And Piper firmly in control at 57-21. Back with quarter number four in just a moment here on the Warrior Sports Network. With quarter number four. As the teams have swapped directions. Third and one for the Warriors. Strachan, the quarterback, gives it off. Campos leans forward. Gonna be very close. If he's short, they will of course go for it on fourth down. And they do flip the down marker to four.
Really close there by Campos, and this is just kind of no man's land area. So, of course, Nick Rogers is going to like to run it right here. I mean, probably 12 inches, 13 inches for first down.
That's about right, about the length of a football. Campos, the running back, standing to the left of Strachan, the quarterback. Two receivers left, two receivers right. Campos stretching, but if anything, he lost a little yardage, and the Warriors are going to turn it over on downs.
That's a good job there by Houtsville, just getting through the offensive line and getting Campos behind the line of scrimmage for the turnover on downs here. And at this point in the bowl game, it's not about coming back to tie it. It's more about just what plays work and what can you get going for next week.
It's all about momentum for next week. But a good stop by the Hallettsville defense, giving their O the ball at their 29-yard line. New quarterback in the game for Hallettsville. That's Landry Brown, Jr., 6'1", 150 pounds. That was Traydon Williams on the carry that nets just 1 yard.
There defensively for your Warriors was number 90, Evan Castillo. Ben Chapman.
Paul, what do you think the feeling in practice is going into this week? Because we mentioned practice was great this week, but I mean, what do you think a win like this creates the mood in practice this upcoming week?
That, and all you got to say is we're now playing in district. This is now district play. That makes all the difference in the world. Williams on the carry again. Third and a long way. Third and almost a full 10.
I mean, these guys are just, they're connecting. The defenders are connecting. The receivers and the quarterbacks are on the same page. And, I mean, last week you were on the high of you just won one of probably the biggest games in Piper history. And then you come in to this game and then you dominate a team who's top 10 in the state in their respective conference.
And let's not forget that Hallettsville scored first tonight.
Mm. And then they came back with 22 unanswered points. I mean, this is a team who did not get down on themselves, and they capitalized on the opportunities they were given.
Got a timeout on the field. So we'll use this opportunity to take a brief break as well, with Piper leading 57-21. Back in a moment on the Warrior Sports Network.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, Ferris Orthodontics, GVTC, and Comal Independent School District.
That Piper band of Warriors here on the near side. Backup quarterback Landry Brown keeps it. Takes a pop here on the near sideline. Pretty good hit by Trey Parrish.
They got some airtime there, pretty close to the line of scrimmage, and they're going to give it to him for a first down for Hallettsville. But a nice job of the backup quarterback deciding to use his feet for the first down.
Moves it out to the 38. As Joey indicated, that is a first down. Nine minutes to go. Running play near side across the 40 out to the 42. It was Gage Norris with his second nice tackle of the evening.
Yeah, we've talked a little bit more about Norris as this game's gone on, gets his body involved on that play, stops about a 5 yard pickup.
Second and five, 8.5 left.
Second down for the Braves.
on what has been a beautiful night for the Piper Warriors. This time, Hallettsville brings two wide receivers to the near side in a two-back shotgun look. I believe that's Traydon Williams on the carry. Shy of the first down, it'll be third and about three.
For your Piper Warriors, number 55, Calvin Spurgeon.
2 yard pickup there for Hallettsville. Not really anything going right here. We'll see if Hallettsville two down territory here. You're at midfield. Why not go for fourth down?
No reason not to.
Yeah. I mean, as we've already talked about entering this fourth quarter, it's all about, these are all about, I mean, in real game scenario where you just get to basically the practice, I guess.
Third and three. And the quarterback, Landry Brown, on the keep. Out to about the 48-yard line. Nice stop by Hector Rodriguez for the Warriors. Does not net the first down. It's fourth and one.
Fourth and short. On your feet, Warrior fans.
Okay, on fourth and one. Warriors in their three-man defensive front. Landry Brown keeps it. Be very close to the first down at about the 49-yard line, and yeah, he's got the first.
Landry Brown just kind of doing a spin move there. Uses his body to pick up the first down, about a 3 yard pickup there for Hallettsville, and moving the chains forward.
Coming up, we'll announce the American Interiors Piper Warriors Players of the Game, sponsored by Brad Hopper at American Interiors, proud sponsors of Piper High School. First and 10, Hallettsville from the Brahma 49. Just over 6 minutes remaining. Running play, far side. That's Jordan Harper Murphy on the carry. Gain of almost four, and it'll be second down.
7 yard line.
Paul, what a game. 28 points off of turnovers for this Piper team, 22 unanswered points. I mean, just the numbers, when you break them down, it continues to tell an amazing story for this Piper team tonight.
They are really peaking at the right time, heading into district play next week against Bastrop. On second down. Again, that's Traydon Williams on the carry. Going to be about a yard shy of the first.
Close to first down yardage. It is a first down.
Nope. They say he's got it. Let's see. Yep, they're moving the chains.
Bastrop's going to be a fun game as well. Lots of great athletes, but we've seen some great athletes come into both here at Piper High School and then on the road out in Davenport, Lander Glen. We saw some good players. Wimberley, we saw some amazing players as well. But Coach Rogers has just done such a great job to adapt to these amazing high school athletes and create the game plan that works perfectly for this Warrior team.
You can see this program growing right before your very eyes. First down. And the ball carrier, Traydon Williams, picks his way for a gain of about five.
Williams, there defensively for your Warriors, was number nine. Braden Reed brings up second down for the Braves.
Knows the ball just outside the 30-yard line. And this is the 11th play of this drive.
Just working the clock here, but other things about this schedule as well. You play Bastrop before you get a bye week. And Paul, I think the bye week is placed perfectly for this Piper team after
Absolutely.
5 weeks of football.
And then after that, they play at Kerrville Tyvee. And Tyvee is back. I've seen a lot of their football so far, and they're pretty good.
Now, Kerrville Tyvee, I mean, throughout the years, that's another program that historically has been really good. And as you said, a team who's back on track, and it's going to be a tough game, especially going into their house. Very
small gain on the play. Boy, what a picturesque that place that is.
Tackle. Yeah. Warrior defensive.
Third about two. Once again, that's Williams on the carry. And from here, it looks like he's just shy of first down yardage. Coming up in just a moment, we'll end the suspense and name those outstanding offensive and defensive players of the game for the Piper Warriors.
Long drive from here for Hallisville. Around 8 minutes gone by off the clock. And Hallisville just working on that time management as we close down to the final 2:45.
Here we go on fourth and one. And the quarterback, Landry Brown, picks his way. He'll have the first down just inside the 30-yard line. And I see no reason, fellas, friends, to prolong the suspense here. Tonight's Warriors offensive and defensive players of the game are offensively Jake South, the outstanding senior quarterback with 5 touchdown passes. And there have been any number of great defenders tonight for the Warriors. But Caden Glass really stood above because he was so versatile and made so many plays and was in on so much action.
Yeah, I'll start off with the quarterback, Jake South. He looked so comfortable in the pocket tonight. He was a field general. He was throwing the ball all across the field beautifully, and then going to the defensive side. Caden Glass, as I talked about in the pregame show, a guy who could cover sideline to sideline, and he did that tonight. Stopped the running back, stopped the quarterback. He did it all, and what a great performance by both of those two guys tonight.
That was Gage Norris on the stop for the Warriors, who himself has really come on here in the second half. Second down, running play, far side, and Hallisville is going to score a touchdown.
By number 32, Gage Norris of the Ravens takes the ball all the way down.
Nice cutback there by Gage Norris around the 15-yard line, cut left, found the opening on the left side of things, and he ends up jogging into the end zone.
Gotcha.
For the touchdown.
Ty Tomek on for the PAT, sends the ball on its way in between the uprights. So a nice job there offensively by Hallettsville. And with 1:10 remaining in the ball game, our score is now Piper 57 and Hallettsville 28.
The official scoring drive, 15 plays, 72 yards, and probably the longest drive of the season so far, 10 minutes and 2 seconds, capped off by a rushing touchdown for number 32, Gage Norris, with 70 seconds to go here in quarter number 4.
So a very satisfying night for these Piper Warriors and their fans. You know, this is a new school, a real up-and-comer. So they now have 3 wins on the season as they run their record to 3-1. And that, in the young history of this school, is the most wins in a season so far. And understand, they're not anywhere close to done. This team is going to win a lot of football games.
Yeah, this team is not here just to win 3 football games. They are here to make a playoff run, appear in their first playoffs ever. We talked about earlier, Paul. First varsity win on home turf. Also, first time they've won 3 out of the first 4 games. What a night to be a Warrior.
Okay, so Piper goes to 3-1, while Hallettsville suffers its first loss of the year and is 3-1 as well.
Yeah, I mean, we talked about it. You're gonna have those hiccups, and Hallettsville, you just bounce back, and you got to know that going into practice this upcoming week that you were a team who had only allowed 8 points coming into today. So clearly your defense works. Your offense has shown explosiveness, 46-0 last week. So really nothing that Hallettsville should go and reset everything, because it's clearly still a very good football team.
Lots of top flight athletes. So here we go with the best formation in all of football, the victory formation. Strachan takes a knee, and with that we'll take more time off the clock as we move under a minute.
Just one more snap to go, but Paul, what a great performance all around, as we've said multiple times. Offense, defense, special teams, everybody stepped up, and I think they stepped up in a big way, and it's going to be a lot of fun going into practice this week as they get ready to prepare for Bastrop for the 2023 district opener.
Lots of momentum, that's for sure. And Joey, your math is correct. Probably taking a knee one more time will get the job done.
Victory formation, Stratch and kneels the ball down. That will be the last.
And that's going to be it. On a powerful performance by the Piper Warriors. And now we'll see the sportsmanlike handshakes at midfield. Again, Hallettsville's got a really good football team. They're going to be a factor in their district. But the Piper Warriors with a statement tonight. We are so glad that you have been with us, and we've been so honored and privileged to bring this to you. Once again, our final score, Piper 57, Hallettsville 28. So a week from tonight, the Warriors open district play at home against Bastrop. That one will start at 7 p.m. here on the Warrior Sports Network. So until then, along with my partner Joey Gonzalez and our spotter Keith Schmitz, my name is Paul Alexander, bidding you good night from Warrior Stadium.
Tonight's broadcast on Warriors Network is brought to you by Stevens Roofing and Remodeling, Ferris Orthodontics, GVTC, and Comal Independent School District.
Hey, I got another one for you. And just look at the hole in this line. You could drive a truck right through there. I mean, the refrigerator William Perry could get a first down there. But you know who's going to get their number called for this one? Yeah, that's right, Dr. Ferris. He's like a ligating linebacker. Boom, just like that. And that's why Ferris Orthodontics is going to get the MVP for this one.
Tickets?
Yep, I got them right here. I'll see you at 9.
Call GVTC today for our premium Wi-Fi service. because Wi-Fi dead zones are downright
terrifying.
GVTC, official Wi-Fi of the undead.